How to write an application?
Hello everyone, welcome to our English learning YouTube channel Kadambini Srishti, and I am Kadambini. So whenever you have to get some permission from any of our authorities, then what should be the medium of communication or how we can represent ourselves before them? Think. Yes, application is one of such medium that is used everywhere. What is an application? Application is a formal request to an authority to get something. It is also equally important for the high school students to get permission from their headmaster. Today we will discuss how to write an application to the headmaster. So why do students write application to the headmaster? Yes, they generally write application to their headmaster to get permission to grant a leave or to go on an excursion or to arrange extra classes or to arrange a friendly cricket match or football match or to issue the SLC, school leaving certificate, or the conduct certificate. So in this way, there are so many reasons due to which the high school students has to write application to their headmaster. So today we will discuss what should be the format and what are the important tips to write an application to the headmaster. So let us start the topic, how to write an application. Before going to the topic, one request to all my viewers. If you like the video, then click on the like button, and if you think that this video is essential for any of your near and dear ones, then share to them. And if you have any suggestion on this video, then kindly give comments in the comment box. And finally, if you want to watch the coming videos, then you have to click on the subscribe button that is there in red color. Okay, let us discuss the format of an application. So I have made a format on the board. So let us see what are the major parts in this format. So first one is we have to give margin in the top and in the left part, and then we have to start the application from addressing, that is to, and we have to write whom we are writing the application. Then we have to write the medium through whom we are giving this application. And next comes this subject that I have written, SUB subject. So here we have to write, or we have to mention why we are writing this application. And next comes the address, then that is sir. Then here we have two paragraphs. So first paragraph, here we have to write the content, why we are writing this application. And in the second paragraph, we have to write, or we have to request to the person concerned whom we are writing. Then comes subscription, yours obediently. And finally, there comes the name of the student, then class, section, roll number, and on the left side, we have to write the place and date. Okay, so this is the format of an application that is generally used. There may be some variations, but this is the generally used or widely used application. Okay,
we have already made videos on chapters of Odia Medium Government High School English book.
Every application has its 5 focus points. So let us discuss what are those 5 focus points. So first one I have written here, first one is whom we are writing. That matters a lot, whom we are writing the application. This should be the first point that should be there in our mind. Or who is the medium? That is the second point. Then comes the third points. That means what for the application, means reason. Then comes the fourth point here is why we are writing the application. So here comes the body of the application, or we can say the content of an application. Again, this content is generally divided into 2 parts. Now let us see what are those two parts. So I have said them are the two R. So first one is reason and second one is request. So in the first paragraph, we have to write the content, the reason of writing the application, or we have to request in this second paragraph. So in this way, the content of an application has two parts. And finally, the fifth one, the last one, that is the ending part. Here we have different things to mention. So here again, the first one is subscription, means like, for example, yours obediently or your obedient student. Okay, then comes the details of the applicant who is writing the application, and it should be written in this right side. And on the left side, what we have to mention? We have to mention the place and date of the application, means when we are writing the application and where from we are writing the application. So these are the five basic focus points of any application and where we have to give importance while writing an application. Previously, what happened? We have to write the application in the board examination. We have to write application as ourselves, as the applicant. But these days, there came a change in the type of application. Then what is that? So here it happens. In these days, in the examinations, generally, the question itself gives the name of the applicant and the place or the name of the school of the applicants. Sometimes its section or roll number is also given. So we have to write the application accordingly. So there we cannot mention our name in the application. Imagine you are Ramesh Chandra Dale from Bhagavati High School, Khurda. So write an application to your headmaster requesting him to go on an excursion. Then how you will start? So you have to start to Bhagavati High School, Khurda. Then on the bottom, you have to write your name as Ramesh Chandra Dale. Here you cannot write the name of your own school and also you cannot write your own name. You have to go according to the question pattern. Okay, mind it. Otherwise, you will not get appropriate mark.
Don't skip the video and let the high school students watch this video for their improvement.
Let us see what are the five basic tips to write a correct application. So I have mentioned here those five basic tips to write a correct application. So first one is margin. So margin should be given from top and left side. Then second, that means to and subject answer, they should be remain in a single line. Then third point, the first letters of these important words, to, subject, sir, therefore, yours, or the headmaster, should be capital letters. Then fourth point, spelling. Generally, most of the students, they misspell these words. Fifth one is format of date. So this should be the correct format of the dates. Generally, this sort of format is not written in an application. Our BSc Odisha has set a rule on mark distribution of an application. Here I have mentioned how much mark you will get if you write the appropriate or the correct part of an application. So first comes the address to whom we are writing. If you will write it correctly, then you will get 1 mark. Then second comes the sir. Here you will get half mark. So here comma is optional. You can give it or you may not give it. Likewise, comma is not used after to. Then comes the content or the body of an application. Here you will get 6 marks. Then comes yours obediently. This is the subscription part. If you will write it correctly, then you will get half mark. And next comes the signature. For signature, there is half mark. And again, for place and date, date should be written in correct format. So here you will get half mark. Finally, for the address of an applicant, you will get 1 mark. So in this way, total, you have 10 marks for an application. If you write these things correctly, then you will get 10 marks.
Links of our previous videos are given in the description box.
If you will follow these steps, then you will be able to secure marks in application. So all the best. Hope you understand everything. And I have said everything in English. Try to listen in mindfully and carefully. It's very easy. If you will go on watching and listening, then finally, one day, you will surely understand the English words and their meanings. Okay? So keep watching, keep learning until the next video. Thank you.
Thanks for watching the video.